Hello, learners. Welcome to Education Online. I'm your teacher, Madam Dani Susan, teacher of math. Today we're going to have a continuation on solving quadratic equations, but specifically focusing on completing squares. We had one example last time, so we're going to have another example before we move to the next method. So let's solve our next example, which is 100 This is going to help us to understand more on how to use the method. So when given a number like this, we said we're going to divide the value of b, then we divide it by 2 and square it. First we shall add it, then we shall also subtract it. So we're going to do it this way. Let us take this to the other side, whereby we're going to have t squared plus 90 is equal to 36. So if we have it like that, now we're going to have this as t squared plus 90 plus 9 out of 2 squared is equal to 36 minus 9 out of 2 squared. Just like I said last time, you can either choose to work it all on this side, then you take it to the other side at the end of it, or you can start by doing this and you solve it easily. So here now we're going to have our 2 squared plus 9 over 2 squared is equal to 36 minus 36 minus 9 over 2 squared. So with this, this is simply having t plus 9 over 2, but the whole of it squared is equal to, we shall have here 36 minus 9 squared, that's 9 times 9 to give us 81 over 4. So if we have this, we put this out of 1, we get the LCM for the 2. So we shall have our t plus 9, we maintain this side over 2 squared is equal to, our LCM here will be 4, then we shall have 4 times 36 minus 4 divided by 4 is 1, so we shall have here 81. We maintain this, this will be t plus 9 over 2, all of it squared. So we're going to have this side 36 by 4, 4 times 6 is 24. 4 times 3 is 12, 14, so that will be 144 minus 81 out of 4. We maintain our t plus 9 over 2 squared. This will give us 144 minus 18, that is, shall have a 144, 81 here. This is 3, 14 minus 8, that is 7. So this will be 63, so we are now going to have 63 over 4. So we are going to have our t plus 9 out of 2. All of it squared is equal to 63 over 4. So we're now going to introduce square root signs on both sides to get rid of the square sign. Sorry, we shall have it like this. We shall also have it there. So this will go with that. We shall be left with t plus 9 over 2 to give us a root of 63. 3 over root of 4. We can press that on our calculator. Let me leave it under root here. So we shall have root of 63 over 2. So we are having this now. To get our final answer, this is plus or minus, because we need to get 2 of this. So we're now going to get the final values of t. So we're now going to have t plus 9 out of 2. T plus 9 out of 2 is equal to root of 63 over 2. So we shall have t plus 9 over 2 is equal to root of 63. Okay, so we are finding the root of 63, which we said is going to be 7.94. This is plus or minus out of 2. So we're going to say it's either t plus 9 over 2 is equal to positive 7.94 over 2. So we are going to have t plus 9 over 2 minus 9 over 2 is equal to 7.94. This 4 cannot affect anything. We can take to 1 decimal place, 0.9 over 2 minus 9 out of 2. So here we're going to have, this will cancel with this, so we shall have our t as, when you subtract this, this is out of 2, so we shall have 7.9 minus 9. So we're going to get our answer there as a negative. So we are going to have our first value of t as t is equal to negative. 7 minus 9, we're supposed to have a negative. The 7 is a positive. So it's 7 minus 9. Sorry, 7.9 minus 9. So we're going to have a negative of 7, 8, 9. That will be negative 1.1. All this out of 2. Then let's find the second part of t, which is or our t plus 9 over 2 is equal to negative 7.9 out of 2. So we shall have t is equal to 7.9 over 2 minus 9. This is a negative minus 9 over 2. So we're going to have t here. We're going to add negative and negative means we are putting together. So it's going to be 9 plus 7 to make it 16 point. Our LCM is 2. So we're going to have here negative 16.9 as our second value of t. The first value is negative 1.1 over 2, and the second one is negative 16.9 over 2 as being the value of t. So we're going to go to the next method of solving quadratic equation, which says it's the use of the formula. We're going to have the quadratic formula. So we're going to have it in the form ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Initially, we know that this is our quadratic expression for the quadratic equation. When we have this expression is equal to 0, we know that we are solving quadratic equation. But in this case, we are going to use formulas. And for these formulas, the constants here are necessary because we are also going to apply it in the formula. So in general, we are going to say that our formula, which is ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, be expressed as x is equal to negative b plus or minus root of b squared minus 4ac. But the whole of this is out of 2a. This is the expression we are having, ax squared plus bs plus c is equal to 0. You can see that all the constants are being used, but we are equating all of them to x. We are saying, for us to get the final value using the quadratic formula method when given a quadratic equation, first of all, you need to know what's the value of b, what's the value of a, implying you have to compare the given equation with the original format of the quadratic equation so that you can know which constant has which value, in order for you to come and replace it accordingly in the formula. Let's have an example. We're using the formula now, we are applying. So we have these two examples that we are going to use to apply the formula. The first one we are saying, we have x squared minus 8x minus 20 is equal to 0. When you compare this with the original, which is ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, you get to see that the value of a in this case is 1. So we say a is equal to 1, our value of b is equal to negative 8, and the value of c is equal to negative 20. So after knowing that, we are going to use the information we've got here to place into the formula. So in this case, we are saying our value of b is negative 8. So it's going to be a negative negative because the formula original has a negative sign. And the value of b also has a negative sign. So you write both of them there, plus or minus root of. Our value of b is negative 8, but it is squared, minus 4. Times value of a, which is 1, then you multiply it by c, which is negative 20. But all of it you write out of value of a, which is 1. So we continue with a negative will give you positive 8 plus or minus root of 8 squared is a negative times negative will give you a positive. So we shall have here 64 minus 4 times. This is a negative multiplying a negative. So when we multiply the two, we are going to end up with 4 times 2 is 8. So we shall have, but should be a positive because we are having a negative times a negative. So here we are going to, out of 1, even if we don't write, so we are going to continue with our positive 8 plus or minus root of, we add 8 plus 60 to give us 144. So we continue, this will be 8 plus or minus, the root of 144 is 12. So we shall have here our 12. So our two values of x is going to have our two values of x are going to be, the first one we shall have 8 plus 12. Remember, we're supposed to maintain the x here throughout because we are getting the value of x. So our first x will be 8 plus 2 and we shall get x here as 20. And the second x is going to be x is equal to 8 minus 12 and our x is going to be negative 2. Those are the two values of x you get after using the quadratic formula. Let's go to the next example. Our next example B was 6x squared minus x minus 12 is equal to 0. When we compare this with the general, which is ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, we get to know that our value of a is 6. You compare this, okay? Then our value of b is negative 1, and our value of c is negative 12. So after getting this information for the values of the coefficients, we come and write our formula, which is supposed to be negative b plus or minus root of b squared minus 4ac, but all of it out of 2a. Okay, so here we're going to have our value of b was negative 12, so we're going to have, where we see b, we're going to put a negative 12, but 12 has a negative and the formula itself also has a negative. So we're now going to say it's negative 12 plus or minus root of negative 12 squared minus 4 times our value of a, which is 6, times value of c, which is negative 12. The whole of this has to be 2 times the value of a, which is 6. So we're going to continue further and we're going to have the negative times the negative will become a positive. So we shall have here 12. We're having x is equal to. So we shall have 12 plus or minus root of negative 12 squared, that is 144, minus 4 times 6 times the 4 is a negative. So 4 times 6 is 24. 24 times negative 12 to give us a negative times a negative will be a positive. So we shall have here 2, 8, 8. Let's make a correction. B is a negative 1, so here we're supposed to have a negative 1 instead of 12. So we have negative 1. Becomes a positive and this becomes 1. All this out of 2 times 6, which is 12. So we shall continue further as x is equal to 1 plus or minus root of 289, but the whole of this out of 12. So when we go further, we're going to have our x equaling to 1 plus or minus root of 289 is 17. All this out of 12. So we're going to say either x is 1 plus 17 over 12, and that x will be 18 out of 12. 3 can reduce the 2, so we say by 3, 4, by 3, 6. So x is going to be, again, it can be reduced further by 2. By 2, 2, by 2, 3. So here we're going to have 3 over 2 as our final first value of x. Then the all part we're going to have x is equal to 1 minus 17 out of 12. We shall have x is equal to negative 16 over 12. 4 is common to both, so we can reduce here by 4, 3 by 4, negative 4. So our second value of x will be negative 4 out of 3. So these two will be our final values of x after working out this number. So we're going to continue further with the next example, which is example C. It says the length of a rectangle is 5 meters. More than 104 meters squared. Find the dimensions. The rectangle. First of all, when given a question like this, we need to understand. You read the question very well and interpret it before you start working out. The question is saying the length of a rectangle is 5 meters more than the width, and the area of the rectangle is 104 meters, implying we need to let the width to be, because this is the length is 5 meters more than the width. So let's have our rectangle here. We first let the width be M. So we can sketch our rectangle here to help us interpret the question well. So we are saying the area of this rectangle is 104 meters squared, and the length is, because the statement says that the length of the rectangle is 5 meters more than the width. That's why I'm doing the width plus the 5 to give me the length. So our width here will be m meters. So with that, we know that the formula for finding area of a length is area is equal to length times width. So with that, our area is 104 and our length is m plus 5, but we are multiplying it with m. So we come here and get our 104 is equal to, when you multiply this you get m squared plus 5m. So with that, now it gives us the clear picture of now the quadratic equation. When you have this, you simply take this there and you equate the whole thing to zero, and it becomes the same. Now with this, it's the same as having m squared plus 5m minus 104 is equal to zero. We simply brought this across the equal sign, that's why we're having a negative here. Now from this, when you compare it with ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to zero, you get to see that our value of a is 1, then the value of b is 5, and the value of c is negative 104. So what we're going to do now is we are going to have our formula, which is negative b, x is equal to negative b plus or minus root of b squared minus 4ac, but you write the whole this over 2a. So we're going to have our x is equal to, what's our value of b? B is 5, so we're saying negative 5 plus or minus root of negative 5 squared minus 4 times our value of a, which is 1, and we multiply it by c, which is negative 104. All this and the root, then you multiply it by 2 times a, and our value of a is 1, so that will be 2 times 1. To continue, this is negative 5 plus or minus. Our 5 squared is the same as 20 root 5 times 5, when you square negative times a negative, you get a positive 25. Then minus a negative times a negative will give you positive. What is 4 times 104? That is 416. All this out of 2. So if we have this, this is going to be negative 5 plus or minus. We are going to add the 2, 25 and 416. To give us 441, all this out of 2. So we're going to say it is x is equal to root of 441 is 21. So we're going to have negative 5 plus or minus 21 out of 2. So after this, we are now going to separate to get the two different values of x, and we are saying either x is equal to negative 5 plus 21 over 2, which will give us negative 5 plus 21, that will be 16 over 2. So next we are going to have our value of x as 16 divided by 2 is 8. Then or the second value of x for us to get, we are going to have x is equal to negative 5 minus 21, all this out of 2. We shall have x is equal to negative 5 minus 21 to give us negative 26 out of 2. And finally our value of x will be negative 26 divided by 2 is negative 13, and this will be our second value of x. So after getting the values of x, we can have our rectangle back. We had it as m originally. I've mixed it and mixed it with x. You know, math, x is always the easiest letter to be used, but what we have here is supposed to be M instead of X, but they're all letters, so don't get confused, it's the same thing. after getting the value of m, remember we had our length as m plus 5 meters. Then our width is, was m. We had our 104 meters squared here. So now this becomes our, we are having two different values. But for this case, we have to go obviously with the positive one because our area here is a positive. So we are going to have here 8 plus 5. So finally, our answer here will be 13 meters. And here we shall have our value of m as 8. And when you multiply, you'll be in position to get the same answer. Let's have the next example. That will be our example D. It says the parallel sides of a trapezium are h plus 3 and h plus 5 centimeters long, and the distance between and the distance between the n is h centimeters. If the area is 32 centimeters squared, find so we've been given a question that the parallel sides of a trapezium are h plus 3 and h plus 5 centimeters long, and the distance between the n is 8 centimeters. If the area is 32, find C. So first we need to sketch the trapezium. We have two sides being given. Our area is 32. Then the longer side is h plus 5. We are having h here, we have h plus 3. We are given the longer side and the shorter side. So these are the values. So we are going to use the information being given to find the height. And we know that the area for trapezium is a half height into a plus b. Our area is 32 a half h, which we don't know the value into. We have h plus 3, it's a big bracket, then plus h plus 5. We're having two brackets because our the distance has been given, the shorter one and the longer one, all having two letter numbers like h plus 5 is not one like 8 or. So we shall have our 32 here is equal to a half height into, we open the bracket and collect. So we're now going to have h into h plus h will give us 2h. 3 plus 5 will give us 8. So we shall have our 32 is equal to a half into, if we open the bracket, the h will multiply throughout. So we're going to have 2h times h to give us, this will now be 2h squared plus h times h to give you 8h. So we shall have here 32 is equal to, these two can divide both of them, so we reduce it by 2. So we shall have this as 2h squared plus 8h over 2. You multiply 2 here, you multiply to get rid of the 2. So 32 divided by 2 will give us 64 is equal to 2h squared plus 8h. So we can now arrange it and we shall have 2h squared plus 8h minus 64 is equal to 0. Now we've got the quadratic equation. We can now simply know our values. Our a here will be 2, our b will be 8, and c will be negative 64. So we write our quadratic formula, which says x is equal to negative b plus or minus root of b squared shall have here b squared minus 4ac, the whole of it out of 2a. Our b in that case is a positive 8, so we're going to have negative 8 plus or minus root of h squared minus 4 times our a, which is 2, then we'll multiply it by negative 64. All of it out of 2 times our value of a, which is 2. Shall have here negative 8 plus or minus 8 squared is 64 and a root minus 4 times 2 is 8, and 8 times 64 will give you 512. Becomes a positive because a negative times a negative will give you positive. 4 times 2, 8. 8 times 64 will give you 512, and write the whole of this out of 4. So with this, we are going to have negative 8 plus or minus 64 plus 512 will give us 576 and a root, all this out of 4. So we're going to have here negative 8 plus or minus root of 576, which will give us 24. But you write the whole of it out of 4. So we're going to continue more and have this as negative 8 plus or minus 24 over 4. We shall have the first one as a positive, the either part. Either our first value of x should be that. So we're going to have negative 8 plus 24 to give us positive 16 over 4. And by 4, 1 by 4, 4. Our first value of x will be 4. Then on the or part, we shall have our value of x being negative 8 minus 24 over 4. So the next value of x will be negative 8 minus 24 will give us negative 32 over 4. Finally, we shall have negative 32 divided by 4 to give us negative 8. So these two are going to be our final values of x after solving that number. So after getting this, we go back to our trapezium. Our area was 32 meters squared. Then we had h plus 3 here, which will now equal to, and our value of h here will be 4. Then this will be 4 plus 3 to give us 7 meters. And the longer side was h plus 5. So we shall have 4 plus 5 to give us 9. The reason why we are taking the positive, the negative will also work, but it depends on the circumstance. An area cannot be negative. So we are using the positive 4. And when you put it, it will give you the exact answer. 7 times 9 is, okay? So with this, I would like to thank you for today's lesson. I remain your math teacher, Madam Dani Susan. We keep it education online till we meet again.